Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. As a first-time mom who has been through a 15-month motherhood journey, I would love to share my experience to help as many new moms as possible. So in today's video, I'll be sharing the plates and bowls that my baby used since she started her baby-led weaning self-feeding journey from 7 months. If you haven't subscribed my channel yet, make sure to click the subscribe button so you won't miss my update. My daughter started her first food with this green Easy Peasy Happy Mat. I love the smile design as it encourages a positive mealtime experience. The mat catches a lot of mess. It is dishwasher, microwave, and oven safe. However, there are something I don't like about this mat. The suction power doesn't work as good as always. The plate is hard to be moved horizontally because of the friction, but it is very easy to be picked up vertically sometimes. Con number two, this mat might be too large to fit a high chair that has a small tree or has a divided design on the tree like mine does. So I bought this bumpkin silicone one dish meal plate. It is 8-inch cross. It's freezer, microwave, and dishwasher safe. It's easy to clean, I mean getting the food and grease off. It does leave food smell on the plate even after washing it. The suction power works great until 1 month later. My baby could pull up the plate by starting to pull the corner at the bottom. I was kind of frustrated, I thought it could last long. I started to looking for one dish meal plate with strong suction after this. Luckily, I found this OXO suction plate that my baby uses the most. She started to use it at 10 months. Now she's 15 months. She's still using this plate. This plate is great for presenting the food. As you might already know by watching my other baby-led weaning feeding videos, I always try to make sure the food is presented beautifully layered so it can not only increase her interest in eating, but also help her concentrate on the food. I'm not saying you have to do this, it is just a trick you can use that might be helpful if you have a picky eaters at home. If you haven't watched those videos, make sure to check them out. There are many baby-led weaning meal ideas that might be helpful to you as well. The other great feature of this plate is this removable suction base. You can attach and detach the suction pad by twisting it at the bottom. There's an opening that makes removing the plate simple for adults but tough for kids. Baby will take the step of using realistic plate that adults use eventually, so this great removable suction base feature can provide a smooth transition without spending extra money. This plate is very easy to clean since it's made of plastic. It's easier than those silicone ones. The only con of this plate is that there can be lots of scratches left on the surface of the plate if your baby uses fork or spoon it a lot. Well, it doesn't bother me. I don't feel like it's a big deal to me. I highly recommend this plate. They do have divided plate as well. I'll put the link down below in the comment if you want to check it out. The last plate I want to share with you is this silicone divided plate from BRVTOT. I don't even know how to pronounce their brand name, to be honest. It is freezer, dishwasher, and microwave safe. I like the irregular design. The deep wall design is just great for yogurt, cereal, or juicy food like chicken noodle soup. It's easy for baby to scoop and make less spillage. Now I want to talk about the pros and cons of the texture design on the surface of the plate. My baby loves to feel the texture when she's hand-eating, so I think it's a great idea to encourage baby to feed themselves with their hand. However, this design can be negative for babies who use fork or spoon to feed themselves, because the texture will cause resistance that makes it a little bit more difficult for your little one to scoop. With the texture design, it is a little bit more difficult to clean as well compared to those ones without texture design. Okay, next, I'm going to show you all the bowls that we have. The first one is the fancy looking silicone steam bowl from Ola Baby that my baby barely used. I'm so sorry, I couldn't find the bowl anymore, so I'm showing you the product picture. You can set this bowl on the steamer or in the pot by easily pulling the base on the bottom. I think my baby only used it once or twice, mainly because it does not have suction power. I don't feed my baby, I let her feed herself from the very beginning, so the suction power is a must. Otherwise, it will just end up with wasting a lot of food and not getting full at the same time. But don't get me wrong, it is a great bowl. We just don't really need it, mainly because we have a baby food maker that has steam feature. If you do need a steam bowl, this is absolutely a great option. The second bowl we have is a Munchkin plastic suction bowl. It's a 3-pack set that comes in 3 different sizes. The suction power works great. The only concern I have for these bowls is that the heart shape area in the bowl can get dyed with food color. Once I served some carrot puree to my baby with this bowl, and I found that it was dyed yellow. I was not able to get rid of it no matter how many times I tried to wash it, so I immediately stopped using these bowls. The third bowl is our favorite that my baby used the most. It is a plastic suction bowl from OXO. I bought it along with the plate that I just showed you all. It is just as good as the plate. Highly recommend. It is bigger than most other bowls, and it has the same features as the plate. It's great for serving oatmeal, yogurt, or cereal. I know it can be overwhelming for first-time mom to start baby solid. I hope this video did provide some helpful tips. I'll put all the links of the products that I mentioned in this video down below in the comment. If you enjoyed watching the content I created, please smash the like button. Let's help more moms!